corrosion of aluminium and aluminium alloys. Corrosion attack on aluminium surface is usually quite obvious since the products of corrosion are white and generally more voluminous than the original base metal. Even in its early stages, aluminium corrosion is evident as general etching, pitting or roughness of the aluminium surfaces. Note: aluminium alloys commonly form a smooth surface oxidation, which is from 0.001 inch to 0.0025 inch in thick. This is not considered detrimental as such a coating provides a hard cell barrier to the introduction of corrosive elements. Such oxidation is not to be confused with the severe corrosion discussed in this paragraph. General surface attack of aluminium penetrates relatively slowly but is speeded up in the presence of dissolved salts. Considerable attack can usually take place before serious loss of structural strength develops. However, at least three forms of attack on aluminium alloys are particularly serious. Number one, the penetrating pit type corrosion through the walls of aluminium tubing. Number two, stress corrosion cracking of material under sustained stress. And number three, the intergranular attack, which is characteristic of certain improperly heat treated aluminium alloys. Chemical cleaning of aluminium alloys. Cleaning method will vary according to the extent and location of the corrosion and the specification of the alloy concerned. General guidance on some recommended methods of cleaning are given below. Now, in this A, light corrosion deposits on aluminium alloys can often be wiped off with solvents or detergents which will leave a clean surface ready for pre-treatment and reprotection. The use of non-flammable preparations which are free of caustic substances is recommended. Swabbing with a trichloroethylene is not advised because concentration of the fumes can be harmful, and in any case the function of this chemical is to remove grease and not corrosion products. When solid particles are held in suspension in surface grease, they will be removed if the parts can be immersed in boiling trichloroethylene liquid. While this is seldom a practical method of cleaning aircraft structural parts during maintenance, the use of an inhibited phosphate chemical brighter is also recommended. Heavy deposits on clad aluminium alloys should be removed chemically because mechanical cleaning will take off the protective cladding and expose a greater area of the core to be subsequent corrosion. Preparation of the thickened phosphoric acid are recommended for these purposes. All other material, including non-clad aluminium alloys, should be masked to prevent them being attacked by the acid. The corroded surface should then be brushed with the acid and, after an interval of not more than 3 minutes, scrubbed with a stiff non-metallic brush until all corrosion products are removed from pits, rivets, heads, etc. The surface should then be rinsed off with generous quantities of water to remove all traces of remaining acid and should then be thoroughly dried. Now, C. Heavy deposit on non-clad aluminium alloys can be removed mechanically, that is, by scraping, wet sanding with fine sandpaper, or by light abrasion with aluminium wool. In brackets, steel wool should not be used, provided dimensional tolerances are not exceeded. A general purpose surface wash, which will not form a base of painting, can be made up as follows: butyl alcohol 40%. Isopropyl alcohol 30%, phosphoric acid 85% solution 10%, water 20%. These are all by volume. The alcoholic phosphate wash should not be used on high strength wrought aluminium alloys such as DTD 5024, 5044, 5114, and 5124. On other alloys, it should not be allowed to remain on the surface for longer than 15 minutes. In fact, shorter times are desirable, particularly if the temperature is high. It It should be applied with a soft cloth on a bristle brush, washed off with a water and the surface dried. As an alternative, the preparatory brush on solutions mentioned in paragraph above. Paragraph which I will come through may be used. Now D, the use of phosphoric acid corrosion removers is usually followed by the application of the chromate bearing conversion coating treatments such as the allochrome series. These remove the final traces of corrosion and provide an improved surface condition for painting. The application of 10% chromate anhydride, solution for a few minutes is also efficacious, particularly on polished skin. Treatment of components. These are all for old metals which are being corroded, such as iron, other metals. Now this degreasing, the trichlorethane vapor method, which is given in the leaflet BL/6-8, is satisfactory for most aircraft materials, but in cases of heavy contamination of the following alternatives may be used. Now we are going much concerned about the aluminium alloys, so we will go for the aluminium alloys. Mild alkaline baths effectively remove grease from aluminium, but the bath should be inhibited to limit attack on the metal. A satisfactory bath can be prepared from a 4 to 5% weight by volume 36 to 80 kg. Its weight to 80 ounce per gallon of a mixture of crystalline trisodium phosphate and sodium metasilicate in proportion between 2:1 and 1:2 weight in bracket if anhydrous trisodium phosphate is used. The proportion will be between 1:1 and 1:4 or without a suitable wetting agent. General corrosion of aluminium can be more effectively treated in place than corrosion occurring on other structural material used in aircraft. Treatment includes the mechanical removal of as much of the corrosion products as practicable and the inhibition of residual materials by chemical means, followed by the restoration of permanent surface coatings. Relatively pure aluminium has considerably more corrosion resistance compared with the stronger aluminium alloys. Advantage is taken of this by laminating a thin sheet of relatively pure aluminium over the base aluminium alloy. The protection obtained is good and the alkaline surface can be maintained in a polished condition. In cleaning such surfaces, our care must be taken to prevent staining and marring of the exposed aluminium, and more important from a protection standpoint, to avoid unnecessary mechanical removal of the protective alkaline layer and the exposure of the more susceptible aluminium alloy base material. A typical aluminium corrosion treatment sequence follows. Number 1. Remove oil and surface dirt with any suitable mild cleaner prior to abrasive cleaning of aluminium surfaces. Number 2. Hand polish the corroded area with fine abrasive or with metal polish. Metal polish intended for use on clad aluminium aircraft surfaces must not be used on anodized aluminium, since it is abrasive enough to actually remove the protective anodized film. It effectively removes these stains and produces a high lasting polish on unpainted alkaline. If a surface is particularly difficult to clean, a cleaner and brightener compound for aluminium can be used before polishing to shorten the line and lessen the effort necessary to get a clean surface. Treat any superficial corrosion present using an evenly wiped down material. An alternate treatment is processing with a solution of sodium dichromate and chromate trioxide. Allow this solutions to remain on the corroded area for 5 to 20 minutes and then remove the excess by rinsing and wiping the surface dry and Dry with a clean cloth. Number 4. Overcoat the polished surfaces with waterproof wax. Aluminium surfaces that are to be subsequently painted can be exposed to more severe cleaning procedures and can also be given more thorough corrective treatment prior to painting. The following sequence is generally used. Number 1. Thoroughly clean the affected surface of all soil and grease residues prior to processing any processing. Any general aircraft cleaning procedures may be used. Number 2. If residual paint films remain, strip the area to be treated. Procedures for the use of paint removers and the precautions to observe were previously mentioned in this chapter under surface cleaning and paint removal. Number 3. Treat superficially corroded area with a 10% solution of chrome acid and sulfuric acid. Apply the solution by swab or brush. Scrub the corroded area with the brush while it is still damp. While chromic acid is a good inhibitor for aluminium alloys, even when corrosion products have not been completely removed, it is important that the solution penetrate to the bottom of a pits and underneath any corrosion that may be present. Thorough brushing with a steel fiber brush should loosen or remove most existing corrosion and assure complete penetration of the inhibitor into crevices and pits. Allow the chromic acid to remain in place for at least 5 minutes. Then remove the excess by flushing with water or wiping with a bed cloth. There are several commercial chemical surface treatment compounds similar to the type described above, which may also be used. Number 4. Dry the treated surface and restore recommended permanent protective coatings as required in the accordance with the aircraft manufacturer's procedures. Restoration of paint coatings should immediately follow any surface treatment performed. In any case, make sure that corrosion treatment is accomplished or reapplied on the same day that paint refinishing is scheduled. Aluminium alloys treatment should be selected to suit the nature of the parts and to prepare them for the finish specified in the drawings for or repair scheme. Some suitable process for the preparation of clad sheet for paintings are described in DEF STN 03-2. They are the use as an alternative to etch primers when preparatory processes are used in the manufacturer's instructions should be carefully followed to ensure that the fatigue resistance of the metal will not be lowered. In which a chromic sulfuric acid process. After designing and rinsing the parts, they should be immersed for approximately 20 minutes in one of the alternative solutions given below. The temperature of the solution should be maintained between 43 degree to 65 degree centigrade, or in bracket 110 degree to 150 degree Fahrenheit. This process should be used for spot welded or tested assembly, but is satisfactory for casting, forgings, extrusion, etc., provided they are thoroughly rinsed and dried afterwards. Solution 1. Sulfuric acid, specific gravity 1.84, chromic acid, CrO3, and water, all by 15% by volume, 5% by weight remainder. Solution 2. Sulfuric acid, specific gravity 1.84, sodium bichromate and water, 15% by volume, 7.5% by weight remainder. Now B. Phosphoric acid process. The constituent of an alkalic phosphate was are given in paragraph above, which we have described. This solution can be used in a mild steel tank to pickle aluminium alloy components. A variety of proprietary solutions containing phosphoric acids are also available Some of this build up a thin phosphate film, which provides a good base for painting. However, a distinction should be made between phosphoric acid processes, which create phosphate films, and those which only clean and etch. The proprietary cleaning process listed in DTD 900 include titanine metal degreasing paste, xenolite AKSI etching compound, and the ICI deoxidizer process 202. These are materials which can be brushed over aluminium assemblies, including parts which are riveted together. But care must be taken to wash all surfaces thoroughly after treatment, drying carefully after washing. Washing deoxidine 170, a hall deep process which is suitable for both steel and aluminium alloy. Another treatment not covered by the specification is dioxidine 125, which can be applied to both these metals by fold dipping or by brushing. If any of these treatments are applied by brush, all crevices and seams should be blown out with compressed air before proceeding to paint the treated area. Painting should follow promptly, since none of these treatments builds a resistant film. Now see chromic phosphoric acid process. After degreasing and rinsing the parts, if specified in the maintenance manual or other appropriate instruction, they should be immersed in a near boiling aqueous solution as follows for 20 minutes if of sheet material, or up to 1 hour if cast. Chromic acid in bracket CrO3 0.75 to 1.0% weight by volume in bracket 7.4 to 9.9 gram per liter in bracket again 1.2-1.6 ounce per gallon. Phosphoric acid specific gravity 1.75, 0.5-0.75% volume by volume in bracket 5.5 to 7.4 centimeters cube per liter, that is 0.8 to 1.2 ounce per gallon. The use of dioxide CX24 followed by allochrome 1200 is recommended. Allochrome 1200 or other similar conversion coating treatments should be used after pickling process, particularly phosphoric acid, prior to painting, except when etch or pass primers are to be used. Of anodized surfaces. As previously stated, anodizing is a common surface treatment of aluminium alloys. When this coating is damaged in service, it can be only partially restored by chemical surface treatment. Therefore, any corrosion correction of anodized surface should avoid destruction of the oxide film in the unaffected area. Avoid the use of steel wool, steel wire brushes, or severe abrasive materials. Aluminium wool, aluminium wire brushes, or fiber bristle brushes are the approved tools for cleaning corroded anodized surfaces. Care must be exercised in any cleaning process to avoid unnecessary breaking of the adjacent protective film. Take every precaution to maintain as much of the protective coating of as practicable. Otherwise, treat anodized surfaces in the same manner as other aluminium finishes. Chromic acid and other inhibitive treatments tend to restore the oxide film. Treatment of intergranular corrosion in heat-treated aluminium alloy surfaces. As previously described, intergranular corrosion is an attack along grain boundaries of improperly or inadequately heat-treated alloys, resulting from precipitation of dissimilar constituents. Following heat treatment in its more severe form, actual lifting of metal layers or bracket exfoliation occurs. More severe cleaning is a must when intergranular corrosion is present. The mechanical removal of all corrosion products are visible delimited metal layers must be accomplished to determine the extent of the destructions and to evaluate the remaining structural strength of the component. Corrosion depth and removal limits have been established for some aircraft. Any loss of structural strength should be evaluated prior to repair or replacement of the part. Treatment of aluminium alloys. From the another text, corrosion of aluminium in general can be more effectively treated in place than corrosion occurring on other structural materials. Used in aircraft treatments include the mechanical removal of as much of the corrosion products as practicable, and the inhibition of residual materials by chemical means, followed by the restoration of permanent surface coating. Figure I am giving you to show typical corrosion removal and treatment procedures for aluminium alloys. In which A is a mechanical corrosion removal. After all the paint has been removed, all traces of the corrosion product, the gray or white powder, must be removed from the surface. Very mild corrosion may be removed by using a neutral household abrasive cleaner such as Bonami, but be sure that the abrasive does not contain chlorine. Nylon scrubbers such as Scotch Brite pads can also be used to remove this mild corrosion. More severe but not heavy corrosion can be removed by brushing with aluminium wool or with an aluminium wire brush, which I have read earlier also. Now, caution. Do not use a steel wire brush or steel wool as traces of the steel will embed by the aluminium and cause severe corrosion. These lines are repeating. So, blasting the surface with glass width smaller than 500 mesh can be used to remove corrosion from the pits. After using abrasives or brushings, examine the metal with a 5 to 10 power magnifying glass to make sure that all traces of the corrosion have been removed. Severely corroded aluminium alloys must be given more drastic treatment to remove all of the corrosion. Rotary files or power grinders using rubber wheels impregnated with aluminium oxide may be used to grind out every trace of corrosion damage. Watch carefully to be sure that the minimum amount of material is removed, but that all of the damage has been cleaned out. After an examination with 5 or 10 power magnifying glass shows no trace of corrosion remaining, remove about 2/1000 of an inch more material to be sure that the ends of all of the intergranular cracks have been glazed. Finish by sanding the area smooth with 280 grit, then 400 grit abrasive paper. Clean the area with solvent or an emulsion cleaner and neutralize the surface with an inhibitor. B. Chemical neutralization. After removing all the corrosion products possible, treat the surface with a 5% chromic acid solution to neutralize any remaining corrosion salt. After the acid has been on the surface for at least 5 minutes, it should be washed off with water and allowed to dry. Allodyne treatment conforming to MIL-C-5541 will neutralize the corrosion as well as forming a protective film on the surface of the metal. Its application is discussed under the heading of surface oxide film chemical treatment. Now see protective coating. Number one is cladding. Pure aluminium is considered to be non-corrosive. This is not altogether true. However, because aluminium readily acts with oxygen in the air to form an oxide film, This film is so dense that it does not allow air to reach the surface of the metal, and there will be no more action once the film has formed. Pure aluminium, though, is not strong enough for aircraft structure, and it must be alloyed with other metals to get the desired strength. Anytime we have an alloy, there is the possibility of getting dissimilar metal corrosion, and the surface of the metal must be protected. The aluminium alloy skin of an airplane may be protected from corrosion and at the same time made attractive in appearance by a coating of pure aluminium. This is called cladding. In the manufacture of clad aluminium, pure aluminium is rolled onto the surface of an alloy. It actually penetrates the alloy and becomes a part of it, accounting for 5% to 10% of the total sheet thickness. This cladding is anodic to the core material, and any corrosion that takes place will attack the cladding rather than the core. The oxide film that forms on the cladding is extremely thin, very tight and transparent, and will prevent further corrosion damage. Now, number two, surface oxide film. The characteristic of aluminium is aluminium to form an oxide film on its surface, a film that resists further oxidation is of real value in protecting the aluminium from corrosion. Metallurgists have found ways of forming films on metal surfaces that are hard, decorative, waterproof, and airtight. There are two ways this film may be formed. It is most generally done in the factories by an electrolytic process known as anodizing in the field. The film may be formed by a chemical process known as anodizing. Number A, electrolytic treatment. In this anodizing process, the part to be treated is cleaned in a hot water bath with a special non-caustic soap solution, and then becomes the mode in an electrolytic process. Becomes the anode in an electrolytic process. Chromic acid and water are used as the electrolyte. After the oxide film has formed, the part is washed in hot water and air-dried. Aluminium treated by this process has not been appreciably affected by regard to its tensile strength, its weight, or its dimensions. The anodic film on aluminium alloy is normally a light gray color, varying to a darker gray for some of the alloys. Some aluminium alloy parts, such as fluid lines, fittings, are dried for identification, with the dye applied in the anodizing process where it colors the oxide. When the oxide film first forms, it is an aluminium hydroxide, which is porous and quite soft. In the condition, it readily absorbs dyes, but as it converts into aluminium oxide, it becomes hard and non-absorbent and forms the protective film needed to shield the metal from moisture and air to prevent corrosion. The anodic film on aluminium alloy is an electrical insulator and must be removed before any electrical connections can be made. Bonding steps are often connected directly to an aluminium alloy part, and for this attachment, the anodized film must be removed by sanding or scraping. Now, B, chemical treatment. When small parts are fabricated in the field, or when the protective anodizing film has been damaged or removed, the part may have a protective film applied by a chemical rather than an electrolytic method. This process uses a chemical that meets specification, AMIL-C-5541, and is available under several proprietary names, such as Allodyne 1201, or if an invisible film is needed, Allodyne 1001. These materials should be applied to the surface after all traces of corrosion has been mechanically removed. The surface should be cleaned with a metal cleaner until it will support an unbroken water film or breaker and bracket water break test. Any break in the film of rinse water indicates the presence of wax, grease or oil on the surface, and further cleaning must be done. While the surface is still wet with rinse water, brush or spray on a liberal coating of the chemical. Allow it to stand for from 2 or 5 minutes and then rinse it off. Keep the surface wet while the chemicals is working. Because it is allowed to dry, streaks will appear and the film will not be adequately protective. Only an area of such sites that can be kept wet should be worked at any one time after the chemicals has had its full working time. It should be finished from the surface with a spray of fresh water. If a swab of a brush is used, care must be taken not to damage the film, which is quite soft while it is not while it is wet. Allow the surface to dry, and after it is dry, it is ready to paint. A satisfactory job produces a uniform Alois brown iridescent film or an invisible film, depending on the chemical used. If a powder appears on the surface after the material is dried, it is an indication of poor rinsing or failure to keep the surface wet during the time the chemical was working. If the powder shows up, the part must be retreated. Warning. Rags or sponges used in the application of conversion coating chemicals must be kept wet or thoroughly washed out before they are discarded. Rags drying with the chemical in them can constitute a fire hazard. Now see, organic film. One of the most universally used corrosion control devices for metal surfaces is a good coat of paint on porous surfaces. Paint adherence is no large problems. But on some metal surfaces, it may be difficult to get the paint to stay. The surface of aluminium must be prepared in order for the paint to have a rough surface on which it can adhere. The surface may be roughened with a mild chromic acid etch or by the formation of the oxide film by either the electrolytic or the chemical method. The surface may also be mechanically roughened by carefully sanding it with 400 grit sandpaper. When sandpaper is used, it is absolutely imperative that every bit of the sanding dust must be removed with a rag damp with thinner before the primer is applied. Soft rags or hand towels obtained from a commercial service do not normally make good rags for washing surfaces prior to paintings. These rags, though clean, frequently contain silicone or other surface contaminants that are incompatible with finishing materials. For lacquer or enamel, the primer which has been used for years in zinc chromate. This is an inhibiting primer, meaning that the film is slightly porous and water can enter it, causing chromate ions to be released and held on the surface of the metal. This ionized surface prevents electrolytic action and inhibits the formation of corrosion. Zinc chromate conforms to specification MIL-P8585A and may have either a yellow green or a dark green color. It may be thinned with toluol or some of the proprietary reducers made especially for zinc chromate. The surface to be painted is cleaned of all fingerprints and any traces of oil. Then a thin wet coat of zinc chromate is applied with a spray gun. Always use an appropriate filter mask or respirator when spraying zinc chromate or other paint products. The synthetic resin base of the zinc chromate primer provides a good bond between the finish and the metal. It also has the property of being a dope proof. That is, aircraft dope will not cause it to lift. When a repair is made or a part is fabricated, it can be given a good coat of zinc chromate and corrosion stopped before it ever gets a chance to start. A wash primer is used in aircraft factories for priming new aircraft before they are painted. These two part primer consist of a resin and an alcohol phosphoric acid catalyst. The material is mixed, allowed to stand for a short time to begin its cure, and sprayed onto the surface with a very light attack of tack coat and then a full bodied wet coat. It cures quickly enough that the top coats may be sprayed on within less than an hour after the surface is primed. Epoxy primers are one of the most popular primers for use under the polyurethane finishes and under any finishes where maximum corrosion protection is needed. This is two-component material that produces a tough dope-proof sandwich coat between the finish and the surfaces. Epoxy primers can be used on aluminium, magnesium or steel. For maximum corrosion protection, they can be applied over a wash primer. The new finishes that are available for aircraft as use give us beauty and protection far greater than the older, more familiar materials, but the critical nature of their mixing and application makes it imperative that the manufacturer's instructions be followed in detail. Most finishing materials are classified as in the terms as a, and as such each of the specific set of recommended materials with which it is compatible. Do not mix materials from one system with another. The manufacturer of a paint system wants you to have good results with his materials, so you will continue to purchase his products in the future.